Rochel, I'm very curious, when and where did we first hear of this concept of double genocide? If we think not about the term, not about the words, but about the idea that there were two Holocausts, that there were two symmetrical genocides, or that there were two catastrophes, the idea, what does that go back to? Not so much the words.
I think that this idea goes to defense. Defense of the Kostanian society and the political elite of it to defend themselves from being accused of killing the Jews, which is confirmed by very many great historians based on documents from all archives, Lithuanian and German archives, about Lithuanian collaboration. I remember somebody came to the museum and said, what do you want? In America's encyclopedia about Lithuania, that these are people who killed, Lithuanians are the people who killed the Jews in World War II. So the Lithuanians needed to protect themselves. How can you protect oneself? It's very simple. You are called a fool, say that you are the fool, not I. Yeah? It's very simple.
When did this defense, as it were, for the perpetration of the local Holocaust start? What are the roots of this idea that it can be used as a defense, the idea that there were two equal genocides or two Holocausts?
It came by the end of the 90s.
Not before?
I think that it came close to the end of the 90s when it was in full voice said about the collaboration in our greenhouse, and in other works also it was said by Lithuanians.
What happened in the late 90s that enabled the idea of two genocides to gain momentum? How would you characterize or contextualize the late 90s?
They say, you killed us. No, you killed us. It's just a game, Dovid. The game has such a simple background. Yeah, you say, I'm bad, you are bad by yourself. And then comes the whole play around. Yeah, you decorate it with various kinds of decorations that it was. Not so, it was not them, it was not that. Piece by piece, step by step, to take from the Holocaust and to add to the another genocide invented here, the other genocide. People are coming to the museum, they are astounded. What is a genocide museum for? Genocide, we knew only one genocide. It's when Jews were killed. We don't know but about another genocide. So it's not true. We have proof for that in our book. We have an entrance book, and there are many entrances, in particular in the 90s. People say it's impossible to use the word genocide for other than the Jews.
Did this movement get a lot more support in the late 1990s when all three Baltic countries in 1998 set up commissions to study both Nazi and Soviet crimes?
I remember when it was established, we all attacked Zingeris, all in the Jewish community, Alperovich and anybody, say, how is it possible that you make parallel to genocides? He said, no, it's not so. There will be separate commissions. One will study the Nazi crimes, the other will study the Soviet crimes. It was a lie, as usual. It became a lie. And it was one commission, and it is played, and it is played around that Jews and Lithuanians were the same victims. What can I say? I have one argument, and this argument is that the Lithuania state survived, and in a way it blossomed in the 90s and in the 80s, and it was the best country among the Soviet republics. The Lithuanians survived as a nation, and they have operas and the theaters and whatever. And the Jews didn't survive. That's all. Jews have been destroyed differently to Lithuanians. My main simple argument. There are no more Jews, because you can't consider 3,000 Jews as a people.